been trying to find a way to make it work. I've been trying to find a way to make it hurt less for you. That was Just For You by Lil Pritchie, and I'm feeling like hitting someone. So if you don't go listen to it, link in the description. You might be the one I hit, or it might be this guy right here. Oh, it's this guy. Oh! Today we're comparing Disney songs to Nickelodeon songs. Which ones are the best? Here with me I have Jonas.
Again, God.
First we have music from The Little Mermaid.
The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the
This is a pretty crazy good song.
Yeah.
Am I the only one who always thought that this was steel drums?
No, oil drums or whatever you call it.
Oil drums? What do they look like?
Maybe that's not the correct term, but you know, those big orbs that have like little indentations around them.
That's steel drums.
Oh.
And that sound is not steel drums. There's way more like sustain in steel drums. There we go.
Yeah.
That is steel drums. That is a banger though, let's be real. And here to face that is SpongeBob SquarePants.
Are y'all ready, kids?
This is like something you would make.
Hear you.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Who lives in a pineapple?
I don't mean musically. I mean the video.
Oh. And I take it as an insult.
I mean, this is like barely a song to me. It's nostalgic, but it's like, this is not good.
It's good in a different way though, because it gets you like vibing.
Does it?
I'm vibing.
One of the most skippable intros ever. You know, I love it, but SpongeBob SquarePants.
Exactly. It's awesome.
Can we agree to put this on Disney, or are we putting our own scores? I'm giving this one to Disney.
And I'm giving this one to Nickelodeon.
Are you really?
I am. Actually, I am.
What?
I didn't think I was going to, but I am. Sue me.
Oh, wow. Okay. So you're witnessing the last time Jonas is on the Room official channel.
It's been an honor.
Has it though?
No, it's been abuse in the workplace.
And here we have Disney's Tarzan. Oh, there's so much good music in this. Oh, freaking. Oh, so good. Phil Collins, man.
Oh. Oh.
It's very good.
Silky smooth voice.
Yeah. I listened to this so many times. I used to drum to this when I was a drummer, just to relax. It's Phil as well drumming on this. He's such a great drummer. And this goes against Jimmy Neutron's Boy Genius. Very cool. The bark bark though.
This is the theme song where they're going meta.
Yeah, for Jimmy Neutron. Yeah, okay, what's your preference and why?
Nickelodeon, no. No, Disney, 100,000%.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to give it to Phil as well. I love that song a lot. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name is Joe from Roomie Official. Here's a meme from the subreddit. A message to the 50% who are not subscribed yet. Do you really want Joe from Roomie Official to beg you on his knees to subscribe? Well, here you go, please. This seems like I planted this here.
It's what the internet is saying. It must be true. We didn't pick the memes.
Here we have Hannah Montana for Disney. You get the limo out front. Hot styles, every shoe, every color. Yeah, when you're famous, it can be kind of fun. You get the best of both. That was David 504. He's bald now. The little laugh there in the end. It's like an anime laugh. And here for Nickelodeon, we have Victorious. Ooh, this is a good one, I think.
I spy Ariana Grande on the cover.
Yeah. I feel this is like Nickelodeon trying to do a Disney thing.
Yeah. Definitely. They tried to do a Disney thing, but the question is, Joel, did they do it better than Disney?
It's a really mean matchup with Hannah Montana. That is just a banger. Gotta give it to Disney once again. Honestly, musically, Disney is kind of murdering Nickelodeon here.
That's a strong word.
No. Oh, for Disney, we have Kim Possible. Call me big man if you want a rich man. When you want to face me, it's okay. Whenever you need me, baby. Call me big man if you want to reach me. Oh, yeah. funky. Doesn't matter where. That is pretty good. Oh, and Danny Phantom. I honestly thought Danny Phantom was Nickelodeon.
Yeah, it is.
No, I meant Disney. I always thought it was Disney. I don't know, because that's a really iconic one.
Young Danny Phantom, he was just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine designed to view a world unseen. He's gonna catch them all, cause he's Danny Phantom. When he first woke up, he realized he had snow white hair and glowing green eyes. He could walk through walls, disappear, and fly. He was much more unique than the other guy.
Much more unique than the other guys. Okay, what do you think?
I gotta say, the Danny Phantom one was a bit... That's the first time I've ever heard it, but the lyrics were a bit too on the nose, explaining like every actual thing that he's doing and what it's about. Felt a bit uninspired. Now, Kim Possible wins for me.
I'm not crazy about the Kim Possible song, honestly. It's like iconic and I've heard it a million times, but... I still gotta give it to it though, because it's kind of uninspired rapping. It's like the worst type of filler lyrics. Just like you're talking about someone who has like superpowers, and then like, oh, so what does that mean? Well, it means that he's much more unique than the other. That's not the main thing you would think about. Here we have Disney's Wizards of Waverly Place. I can't do it. Well, you know everything's gonna be a breeze. Then we'll no doubt justify the means. It can fix any problem with a smash. Is this Selena singing?
Yes. I don't know. But you might find out it'll go
to your head when you write a book. Oh, it is. On a book you never read. She was like a stronger singer when she was younger. It's weird. Or like she sang in a more powerful like way. She sang like a lot of the other Disney stars. I guess I had the same vocal coaches that made them sing in the same way. Everything is not what it seems when you can get all you wanted in your wildest dreams. You might run into trouble. This is very catchy. Is not what
it seems. Wizards from Waverly Place was the song that inspired the riff in Bad Guy. Do 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 do.
Oh. Yeah, so we've had that in some compilations before. And here for Nickelodeon, we have iCarly. This is good.
Yeah.
As far as what gets me hyped to watch a show, this is a energy kick. It's got almost like a Friends theme song vibe, but more energy. I really like that. I'm gonna give that one to Nickelodeon.
And so will I.
Very cool. Here for Disney, we have The Sweet Life of Jack and Cody.
Did you say Jack and Cody?
No, I said Zach.
Ah, okay.
There's a spelling error here. It says Sweeted Life. Researchers failed. Sweeted Life of Jack and... No, I said Jack. The Sweet Life of Jack and Cody. Let's have... The Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
I'm in your mind. Here I am in your life. Oh, look, it's you. Times two. We've got a sweet life. The ending part was the best of the song.
The This Is the Sweet Life part?
Yeah, the hook. It got me hooked.
And every Nickelodeon, we have All That, which I've never heard of in my life.
I've actually seen this lots of times because my friend had the channel and he used to watch this all the time. Now nostalgia kicks in for me.
Oh, super old school hip hop vibes. This must be pretty old. Oh!
Yeah, I think it's early 90s.
This hook is sick. Yeah, I gotta give it to Nickelodeon. That was sick.
Agree.
Here we got for Disney, Hercules. Wow, this is some real classics. Is it gonna be I Can Go to Distant? No. There was a mess wherever you
stepped. Where chaos reigned and the earthquake and fall. Felt like they could have picked a better song from Hercules.
No, you're probably right. This is just their way to do exposition in this movie, right? It's just like, instead of having
this is this is the intro scene.
Instead of having a voiceover be like, once upon a time, they just had them sing it instead. It almost doesn't feel like a real song to me. But yeah, here we have for Nickelodeon, The Fairly Odd Parents. Timmy is an average kid that no one understands. An average kid that no one understands. Isn't that a paradox? Come on, Nickelodeon. Odd parents, Well, between these two, I'm probably going to give it to Fairly Odd Parents, honestly.
Yeah, definitely. If it would have been I Can Go the Distance, that would have won.
Oh, yeah. It was Disney's The Jungle Book. There's some good songs in this one.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your stress.
Is it bad that I think of you a little bit as that bear and me as a kid? Like, not in the parental way where you help me out, but just you're like this dancing tall bear. And they're like, Jonas, can you get the banana from the high shelf?
The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey.
This is such a great song, though.
When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance.
When he's singing, there's this really muddy reverb that goes out into the sides. A little bit distracting. And here for Nickelodeon, we have Hey Arnold. I don't remember this as having a good theme song, but maybe I'm wrong.
Arnold!
Yeah, classic.
Arnold!
That's actually kind of sick.
Yeah. It's groovy.
Yeah, like fusion.
Arnold! Move it, football head!
Hey, Arnold!
That's so minimalist.
There's no song there, but it, as a groove, I like it a lot. I gotta give it to Disney.
I agree.
Here we have Phineas and Ferb for Disney.
I thought they were Nickelodeon for some reason.
Yeah, they feel Nickelodeon.
There's 104 days of summer vacation and school comes.
Is this like Simple Plan?
So the annual problem.
Yeah, what is that?
Is finding a good way to spend it. Surfing tidal waves, creating nanobots, or locating Frankenstein's brain.
It's over here.
Finding a dodo bird, painting a continent, or driving our sister insane. As you can see, there's a whole lot of stuff to do before school starts this fall.
Come on, Barry!
So stick with us, cause Phineas and Ferb are gonna do it all.
That was very well recorded, at the very least. There's some lyric lines that aren't the most ideal. Discovering something that doesn't exist. If you discover it, it does exist.
Yeah, I guess it wasn't as catchy to say discovering something previously known to not exist.
Yeah. And here for Nickelodeon, we have Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. What?
Oh.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
This is
Turtle
like
power.
Literally my childhood. I had all of the toys, everything. Oh my god.
All of the pizza.
All of the pizza. That's why I look like I do.
That's why you're the bear. There's a lot of explaining in this as well, though.
I know, but it's my childhood, Joe.
Yeah. I mean, there's no competition. That is Nickelodeon all the way. Here we are for Disney. That's So Raven.
You could get into the future.
It is Raven singing in this.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's like auto-tune-y. This is how people still rap. That's actually interesting. They kind of sounded like Megan Thee Stallion or something.
It is groovy, come on.
Oh yeah. And here for Nickelodeon, we have The Loud House. Never heard of this show, ever.
Never heard of this either.
Crashing through the crowded halls, dodging girls like ping pong balls, just to reach the bathroom on time.
Huh.
Leaping over laundry piles, diapers you can smell for miles. Guys gotta do what he can to survive.
In the loud house,
duck, dodge, pushing chest, it's how we show our love.
I did not hate that.
I didn't hate it either, but it's hard to compete against the nostalgia of That's So Raven for me.
I'm also gonna give it to Disney. Here we got Disney's Sonny with a Change.
Wait, no, it's Sonny with a Chance. They've written it wrong.
It is. Oh, it keeps happening. Is that Demi Lovato?
Is it? Did she do other things than Camp Rock?
She did the adult parody called Camp.
Bruh.
Yeah, it's Demi. Wow, that looked awesome.
Intense smile.
Oh, I like this intro. There's so much happening. The rock scream in the end. Demi Lovato had kind of like a rock career in the beginning. That's the music she made. She's so much more about soul and stuff now. Here we got Zoe 101. This is the one with Jamie Lynn Spears, right? Britney Spears' little sister. I'm just another kind of girl. This is so nostalgic. What?
Wait, have you seen this before?
Yes, no way. I think my brother must have watched this a lot. That's the only explanation. For me, I gotta give it to Zoe 101. I don't know about you.
I just don't care at this point. No, I actually agree with you. I'm gonna give it to Nickelodeon.
I mean, Demi sings way better, but they should have written a better song for her. Here for Disney, we have DuckTales. Race cars, lasers, aeroplanes. It's a yes. Duck blur. Might solve a mystery. This is the exact best nuance of explaining while also not being like too specific. Might solve a mystery or rewrite history. Like, that's all you need to say.
And it's hella catchy.
It's so catchy. DuckTales, every day they're out there making DuckTales. So good. Probably the best theme song for a cartoon ever.
Yeah.
And here for Nickelodeon, we have My Life as a Teenage Robot, which I've never heard of. It looks very new. It looks flash animated as well. 5 o'clock, get a call to complain. It's not new. At
the
skate park down by the
mall. The resolution's like, nope. Then hustle aliens from annihilating us all. Still, I wish I could go for a walk without rusting in the. They're over-explaining it again, Joel.
Ah, yeah. That's every cartoon. My life. I don't hate this. Yeah, DuckTales are so much interesting. That one goes to Disney, not gonna lie. That was sick. Okay, guys, okay for more music-based videos, okay for music commentary videos. Here's a meme from the subreddit subscribers will know. The camera froze from this point on, but if you've been watching the channel long enough, you know exactly how he looked the entire time anyway, so it's all good. Thanks, Jonas, for joining me for this video, and we will see you tomorrow. Okay, Jonas, jump on a plane and get here so we can play some naked tag.
Okay.